The album reaction that y'all are about to see was actually recorded on March 10th, 2019, but it got blocked because of copyright bullshit. So I did a review on this album with Bud Ding Langley, but recently I just managed to cut enough parts of the songs out to avoid the video getting blocked because of copyright bullshit. So I hope y'all enjoyed this album reaction. So, Ariana Grande just recently came out with her fifth album, Thank You Next, last month, and I've been hearing lots of good things about it. Yes, I do know that I'm a month late with this album reaction, but I've been very busy lately with work and all that other shit. But now, the wait is finally over, bro. Y'all already know that I've already heard Seven Rings and Break Up With Your Girlfriend, I'm Bored. And Seven Rings was an alright song, but it could have been better. And I did love Break Up With Your Girlfriend, I'm Bored. Break Up With Your Girlfriend, I'm Bored is definitely a fire song, bro. But I do admit that Seven Rings and Break Up With Your Girlfriend, I'm Bored weren't the best songs by her. But they were still decent, nevertheless. And the title track of this album, Thank You Next, was very beautiful. And the lyrics in that song were so amazing and deep. I really love the line off Thank You Next where she sung, "Wish I can say thank you to Malcolm because he was an angel." Man, that lyric really hits me hard. Now it's time to hear the full album as a whole. So let's give Ariana Grande's highly anticipated new album, Thank You Next, a listen, shall we? Alright, the first song off this album is called Imagine. Ooh! Well, this is like way different. This is like different singing from her that I've never even heard before. But it's different in a good way, of course. I like that she's trying new things with her vocals. Oh god, she just said, "Me with no makeup, you in the bathtub, bubbles and bubbly." Ooh! Damn, Ariana, the way you singing in this song is different, but I'm living for it. Ooh, that right there sounded very beautiful. She was like, click, 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 and post. Yeah, I can't sing like she can. Y'all know that I fucking suck at singing, man. So if I ever sing in my videos while reacting to a song, just know that it's definitely a joke. My singing is a goddamn joke whenever I try to do it in my videos. So I do know that I suck at singing, so y'all don't come at me in the comment section about that. What? Did she just say, "Kiss me and take off your clothes"? Okay then. Ooh, her vocals are getting more high on this track now. Hell yeah, deliver them vocals, Ariana. Ooh. Ooh, she definitely has the most unique voice of this generation. This is so good. Oh my god. So, she's back to hitting them whistle notes like Mariah Carey. Oh, I'm shook, bro. Like, her whistle notes are so good, just like Mariah's. Wow. That was definitely a good way to start off the album. What the hell? Laptop is tripping. But most of the lyrics off this song were great, but some were kind of random. But overall, it's a good song, and I liked it. I don't know if it'll be one of my favorites off the album yet, but let's just give the rest of the album a listen and find out, bro. Second track off this album is called Needy. Ooh. This song kind of sounds familiar to another song I've heard before. But I could be tripping, but I don't know. Wait, so... So she just said, lately I've been on a roller coaster, trying to get a hold of my emotions. That lyric hits deep. I can relate to that lyric because sometimes in life you can really get into your emotions. Like one day you could be just fine and happy, but then the next day you can be very depressed because of some sad thoughts going through your head and all that other shit. The lyrics in Needy are so great so far, man. Ooh. Oh, you don't give no fucks. Yeah, nobody should. I'm loving that she has snaps in this song. That's very nice. Way too damn needy. Ooh. She got those beautiful violins to end off this song. Very nice, bro. I really love that. That was a very beautiful way to end off that song. I liked it a little more than Imagine, but Imagine is still good though, don't get me wrong. But I like Needy a little more. Third track off this album is NASA. Alright. Wait, so the beginning of this song kind of sounded like a dude speaking through a microphone or something. That was different and kind of random. That dude who sounded like he was speaking through a microphone. I sound like a dumbass right now, don't I? I need to stop. I need to stop acting like a dumbass. I am very sorry for my cringiness, everybody. Hey, this song sounds good also. Ooh. Wow. Wow, I find it kind of ironic how this song is called NASA, and she's saying, I'ma need space. I see what you did there, Ariana. That's genius. I really love what she's doing with this song, making all these references about space and the sun and all that other stuff. Like, this is a pretty cool song, man. Damn, the bass on this song is so badass. The fourth song is called Bloodline.
Because I'm trying to do the best I can, and they can't find something to satisfy me. Look.
Oh, I can already tell that this is gonna be another bop and will probably be one of my favorites off the album. Oh, dude. I love this. Whoa. Whoa. Oh, fuck, man. She just completely switched up with her vocals. Like, first she was singing in her high voice, then was like, love me, baby, are you down? Can you let me know? Damn it. I always sound like an idiot when I try to sing to a particular part of a song. I always humiliate myself when I do that. Any fucking ways. It seems like we're getting into the party vibe songs on this album. Like, the album started off with more slower paced songs. Now it seems like the beats are getting more upbeat and faster pace. Ooh, I really love this chorus. It's very catchy. Yeah. I love it when she goes, yeah. It's so funny and cool. Hey. Yeah, this is definitely another bop. So far, this is my favorite song off the album. Yeah, there is absolutely nothing wrong with this song at all. This is definitely a bop. That was awesome. So far, this is my favorite song off this album. It was so damn catchy and fun, and I really loved the dope-ass reggae vibes in the beat. Her style is so cool, bro. Okay, this fifth track is called Fake Smile. This sounds kind of like a sample from an old song. Oh man, that voice at the beginning just said, after laughter comes tears. Oh man. Ooh. This beat is so cool, man. Oh man. Oh my god, this song is so beautiful, bro. Man, well, when she said, I can't fake like I'm alright, that was very sad. But when she said, ooh, and after that, I can really feel the emotion and pain in her voice. Yes. Yes, a fuck a fake smile. So she just said, I hear the things they write about me. Yes, Ariana, don't let those stupid diva rumors get to you. Your fans, friends, and family know that most of those rumors are fake and that you're actually an amazing, down-to-earth person. Damn, these lyrics really hit hard. Like, I can tell that she really poured out her heart in this song. Yes, this is such a beautiful song. I think I know what this song is about. I'm pretty sure this song is about the extremely bad depression and anxiety she has from her fans getting killed and injured from the bombing at the Manchester concert back in 2017. And also the depression she has from her close friend and ex, Mac Miller, dying. Oh man, I'm pretty sure that Manchester incident is gonna haunt her for the rest of her life. That was such a very devastating incident. Like, let's all take a moment of silence for the Manchester victims and Mac Miller. The next song is called Bad Idea. Wow, so far this song is off to a very amazing cool start with the beat. Dude, the beat to this track sounds like it's highly influenced by EDM and hip-hop. Like, fuck what anybody says. Bad Idea is another bop, bro. I got a bad idea. Damn it. Oh yeah, I was waiting for her to hit that high note. What, is she gonna sing the chorus again or something? Oh wow, the ending of this song kind of sounds a little scary. Well, A Bad Idea is without a doubt another one of the best songs off this album, by far. It has such a dope-ass EDM dance sound to it. And I really love upbeat songs like this. Upbeat songs like this put me in, like, the best damn mood, man. This next song is called Makeup. Ooh, it's kind of giving me Moonlight vibes. What? What? So, okay, let's hear what else she said. Wow, so the way she started off that song was, I wanna fuck with you just to make up with you. That was badass. Well, when it comes to this song, I do love her vocals in it, but I kind of wish more would happen with the beat. But it's an alright song besides that, though. Yeah, it does have a chill, relaxing vibe to it. The next one is Ghostin'. This is the main song off this album I've been looking forward to hearing the most. Bro, I am literally getting goosebumps right now. Ooh. Look at the cars all leaving down. If you were anybody else, probably wouldn't miss the world. I'm not gonna lie, y'all. I might cry while listening to this song. This sounds so beautiful. Yes. Yes. I ain't got much to say. That this song is really I don't know. It's just, it's really hitting me. He just comes to visit me when I'm dreaming every now and then. Oh man. She just sung, "He just comes to visit me when I'm dreaming every now and then." That lyric was obviously about Mac Miller. Mac was always such a very great close friend to her. Man, it really sucks losing a loved one. Losing a loved one is one of the hardest things that can ever happen because I lost my grandpa last April in 2018, and it really fucked me up, man. Like, I know how hard losing a loved one can be, so I can feel Ariana's pain in this song. I am crying tears of joy right now. This is like the most beautiful song that she's ever made. Oh, fuck. I'm sorry for crying, y'all, but I just can't help it. This song is just so beautiful and deep. Feels like I'm floating on a cloud right now, bro. This is so beautiful. Okay, I'm gonna need a little while before I finish off this video. Okay, I think I'm done crying now. So far, Ghostin' is my number one favorite song off this album, and Fake Smile and Bloodline would have to be in second and third place. Ghostin is definitely a true masterpiece, bro.
Okay, the next song is In My Head.
Here's the thing. You're in love with a version of a person that you've created in your head.
So, another person talking at the beginning of that, at the beginning of the song. Man, this entire album has such a cool vibe, bro. Ooh, so far this is another cool ass beat, man. This sounds dope. I thought I knew you well. I got a habit, caught in the moment. Single of beige sheets. We might imagine to create it. Ooh, her vocals though. Okay, so far what I'm getting out of this song is that it's about her singing, about like an imaginary story she made up in her head. Like, I really love the dope concept of this song as well. Oh damn, bro. Damn. To everybody out there who says that Ariana Grande sucks and that she can't sing, look, let me hear you hit a powerful, mind-blowing high note like that without your voice cracking and without you getting vocal cord damage. I'm waiting. Oh, that's right, you can't. It's okay if some of y'all out there don't like her music, but just shut the fuck up with all this bullshit claiming that she can't sing. Because most of y'all can't even hit powerful high notes like her without your fucking voice cracking. I mean, I know I can't. So, I tried hitting a high note, but ended up choking because I can't sing for shit. It was all in my head. Oh, damn it. Yeah, I cannot sing at all. Some of y'all really don't know shit about what real talent is when you hear it. Ariana Grande is known as one of the best female singers of today's generation by most of the music industry. Even Katy Perry, Christina Aguilera, and Britney Spears have all said that Ariana Grande has one of the best female vocals in pop music today. Like I said, it's okay if these people don't like her music, but saying that she can't sing? No, that's a fucking lie and that's fucking bullshit, bro. Never sleep on or deny real talent when you hear it, everybody. What? What was that skrrr about? That kind of like reminds me of the Migos a little bit. Boy, I invented you. Gucci tennis shoes, running from your issues. This song is very unique. Maybe that's the issue. I don't know what to say about this beat. It's just, it's something else, and it's very cool. Okay, so the last three songs off this album, I already heard before. But I'll just show a little clip of my reactions to Seven Rings, Break Up With Your Girlfriend, I'm Bored, and Thank You Next, right now. Ooh, hey. Now, that lyric right there kind of hit me. Like, if y'all don't know who she was talking about when she said Malcolm, that was actually Mac Miller's real name. That, like, they were best friends before they started dating, and they remained friends afterwards as well. Man, I'm glad she has a lyric on here paying tribute to Mac. May he rest in peace. Ooh. Thank you. Next. Okay, I think I like this. I mean, she is experimenting with different sounding beats, and I'm here for it, man. Well, Thank You Next was definitely a true masterpiece. Fake Smile and Ghostin' hit me so damn hard, bro. Like, those songs were so beautiful and so deep. I mean, she's always had deep songs off her previous albums, but those two songs, Ghostin' and Fake Smile, would have to be the deepest lyricism I have ever heard from her. Like, holy shit, man, those songs literally had me in tears. Because whenever I listen to music, I really take the lyrics in. So that's why I sometimes cry when I listen to very deep songs like Fake Smile and Ghostin'.
Like, you can
tell that she really poured out her heart in those songs, and I loved them so much. But my top 5 favorite songs off this album would have to be Ghostin', Fake Smile, Bloodline, Bad Idea, and In My Head. Well, this was my reaction to Ariana Grande's newest album, Thank You Next. She has one of the most unique styles out of any newer singer I've ever heard. Like, this lady has true talent and puts her all into most of her music. And she just really has a creative, unique style that sticks out from the other popular singers. I love that she makes emotional, meaningful songs, but at the same time, she makes dope-ass catchy party songs as well. I hope y'all enjoyed this reaction, and be sure to comment down below some of your favorite songs off this album. Ariana Grande did such an amazing work with this album, and I loved it with a passion. I'll see you guys again in my next video. Peace out, YouTube.